and welcome to Caulfield on what is a glorious day here in Melbourne. We're going to have a great day of racing from Caulfield. Excellent day in Adelaide today with the Goodwood Handicap and also the big race in Brisbane, the Rothmans 100,000 and all races from Rose Hill. Let's check the weather and track in Melbourne today. It is a delightful day. Track officially dead and it will be the key to a number of horses' chances such as Century Judge in race 3. Fine, mainly sunny today, expected top 20, currently 17 degrees. Perfect day, and it's a beautiful day in Adelaide for the running of the Goodwood Handicap today, $200,000 Group 1, and that's where we're taking you for the first event today. It's the Lindsay Park Stud Handicap Race 1. The scratchings are 5 and 15, and the favourite in the first race is horse number 1, Golden Prayer. It has emerald green, red and white V colours, white sleeves and a cap, comes from Victoria, is trained at Cranbourne by Chris Perry. So it's going to be a wonderful afternoon. We'll keep you up to date after the first in Adelaide, let you know about all the scratchings and the selections today. Let's join Ron Paps on a sunny day at Morfordville.
And they're set for the first division of the Lindsay Park Stud. Standing this year, the new stallions Alzeo and Persian Heights, the recent acquisitions at Talak and Bluebird. Racing now, and Wells was slow to begin, and so too are a number of others, but getting away very quickly. Bush Ballard is going to lead Golden Prayer to second. They were followed by Jumara Deep, Little Better the centre, and down on the inside, Slammer in the green cap. A length and a half away, the stablemate Slicey Loon is racing deep. Wells on the inside, and between them came Sabato. They were followed by Harkness before the turn, and then came Celestine. Back towards the inside, and scrubbed up Super Play, not responding. Yangri goes to it with Dream Property, and they were followed further back in the field by Joe's Mark. Well back before the turn, Scones, and last our Cosmic Star, Bush Ballard by 5 at the 400 into the straight. Golden Prayer's done all the chasing. 3 lengths away behind those, Slammer under the whip. They were followed by Wells. This leader's going well. Back in the field, Little Better, followed then by Jumarara at the 200, though Bush Ballard still 4 in front of Golden Prayer. 2 lengths away then, battling on Slammer, followed by Wells, and everything else has given up the ghost, but it's Bush Ballard in front. It might hang on. Golden Prayer is coming out of the ground at it now, but Bush Ballard had the break, and Bush Ballard just in front, grabbed by Golden Prayer, and Golden Prayer, the favourite, got there, I reckon, and by a lip. Second Bush Ballard, third placing went to Slammer, who was there all the way, followed by Wells. They were followed by Yangari. Down the outside, Slicey Loon. Back on the inside section, Super Play ran on again with Celestine. Then our Cosmic Star, Little Better, knocked up. They were followed by Joe's Mark, and then Harkness followed further back by Scones. Well back in the field, Dream Property. Jumara pulled up quickly, beat a few home, and one of the last in was Sabato.
Very close on the first in Adelaide, over the line as Ron Paps called them, 1, 6 and 7, but not much. In Brisbane, the mighty New Zealander Our Poetic Prince has the chance of becoming the first racehorse in the Southern Hemisphere to win $3 million. He challenges the Australians in the Rothmans. In Adelaide, it's the Goodwood, where the Victorians are out to dominate South Australia's showcase sprint. Plus all the action of Steve's Lumley Day at Caulfield and Rose Hill in Sydney. Stephen Quatermain brings us up to date from with the stories 50, from the big sporting events at home and overseas, plus a preview of the football and all the scores throughout the day. And welcome back to Caulfield. As I said, that's what we've got to look forward to today. Lots of sport all around Australia and overseas with the results of the golf and tennis and also the VFL today, and lots of racing. So very good morning to Des Spain and...
You get a run for your money when they jump from the starter's gate. You get a run for your money when they thunder down the straight. The odds are so much better, try your luck and see. You get a run for your money on the TAB. You get a run for your money.
$75 and $55, a hot favourite. Bush Ballard at 80, Slammer $5.45, Trifecta $59.30, and the Quinella $2. Okay, to the scratchings today, and firstly at Caulfield, where we have already told you that the track is dead. Beautiful day, race 1 clear, race 2 Naritzi number 1, is scratched. Race 3, 11, 14 and 15 scratched. Race 4 is clear. Race 5, the big one of the day, the Steve's Lumley, take out 1 Hazy Pond and 15 Gospel Bell. In race 6, scratched 10 Perfect Happiness. Race 7, 1 Lonely Dreamer running in Adelaide today in the Goodwood and 11 Royal Malcolm. And the final event is clear. Scratchings in Sydney with 3 runners to go in for the first event on the program there. In the first, take out 8 and 12. Race 2, 5. Race 3, clear. Race 4, number 9 is out. Race 5, 1, 2, 10. Race 6 is 4, 6, 7 and 8. It's been decimated, that race. Race 7, 3, 9, 12. Race 8, 2, 3 and 4. Almost set for a start in Sydney. Adelaide scratchings, track is dead in Adelaide. In the first, take out 5 and 15. Race 2, clear. Race 3, number 8. Race 4, number 18. Race 5, clear. The big one, the Goodwood, take out 18, 22, 23 and 24. Race 7, take out 2. Race 8, clear. Race 9, take out number 6. Almost set in Sydney, and in Brisbane we'll check the scratchings there. Let's go and join Ian Craig for the first in Sydney at Rose Hill. Heavy track.
With Card Shuck for the Hollandale Southport Cup, and Billy Davenport, his foreman, looking after the filly here today, Starlight Angel. They're ready now. Starters on his stand. They're racing, and Starlight Angel jumped out well, but was quickly headed by Peyton Black. In third position, Turf Romance, and then Lovely Reception, and wider is Dara's Symbol, a length Snow Cap and Canimbla Girl. Then comes River Fleet, a length and a half to Bo Donner and Fiona Adore, a long margin Shining Sequin, and Gouras Queen is last. As they come to the side, the speedy Peyton Black, a length and a half, Turf Romance. Starlight Angel tucked in third along the rails, a length the Snow Cap, followed closely by Lovely Reception. Further back in the field as they near the 600 metres, on the outside, Dara's Symbol, and then Bo Donner, Fiona Dore, River Fleet from Canimbla Girl. Second last is Shining Sequin, and last is Gouras Queen. Onto the corner they go, and the leader, Peyton Black, about a length on Turf Romance. One and a half third is Starlight Angel, and is pulling her away from the rails now, and then Snow Cap and Bo Donner, followed by Lovely Reception. Straightening, and Peyton Black tackled by Turf Romance, and here comes Starlight Angel cruising up to them. Oh, he hasn't let her go yet, and quickly the favourite takes the lead, and she's home and hose. 200 metres to run, it's all Starlight Angel. Peyton Black is stopping, followed by Turf Romance and Bo Donner, but Starlight Angel, a filly that has plenty of ability, revelling in the ground. Second Bo Donner, Peyton Black walking in, will cling on for third, but Starlight Angel's won by a space. Second Bo Donner, third Peyton Black, followed by Snowcap, Turf Romance, Lovely Reception. Then Dara's Symbol, followed by Gouras Queen, Canimbla Girl, River Fleet and Shining Sequin, and Fiona Dore was last.
Over the line, 7, 4 and 2, Starlight Angel, Bo Donner and Peyton Black in Sydney. Very impressive win. And the track is slow, and the scratchings in race 3, this is the first for telecast, take out 7 Nenutera and 18 Harbour Rain. In race 5, 3 Planet Waller and 6 Mirabean. Race 6, take out 5, 11, 19 and 21. Race 7, 5, 11, 19 and 20. Almost a carbon copy. And at race 8, 1, 9, 17, 21 and 22. We're televising races 3, 5, 6, 7 and 8 from Brisbane today. Horses have left the mounting yard for the first on the program at Caulfield. As a big the Quinella was $8.15 for 7 and 4, and the Trifecta $21.05 for 7, 4 and 2. First race in Melbourne coming up in a couple of minutes' time. Dan Malecki calling all races today.
At the moment, they're ready and they're racing. Orchestra Man on the inside, one of the best out with Mighty Dom. Last year's Hamilton Cup winner goes up towards the lead. Still there, the centre, and Caledonian Concord getting up on the inside with Laurie Podridge, trained by Laurie's wife, Ailsa. A length and a half, Cartridge Case goes to about fifth. Spend a dollar on the outside of him. Followed by Solo Bid, the former New South Wales gelding, seventh. Two and a half to Our Orphan. And a length and a half away, last of all, was the Bolt Attack Laban. Mighty Dom's in front, leads a length and a quarter. Only two starts over the hurdles for a first and pulled up at its last performance at Caulfield. Caledonian Concord gets one off the fence with the Grand Annual winning jockey Laurie Poultry. stretch. Then still there third, and Orchestra Man fourth the rail. Spend a Dollar goes up fifth, and then came Cartridge Case, a length and a half to Solo Bid and Nick Arnett. Two lengths to the favourite, Our Orphan, and last of all was Tacloban. They pack up for the first of two down the straight, and Mighty Dom gets over to length in front. Tacloban out the back didn't jump at all that well. They've really packed up. There's only six lengths between first from last. A field of nine in the first race. Mighty Dom in front, but Solo Bid centre light goes up and takes the lead by the jump of the winning post. He sails over that jump about three lengths clear now. Mighty Dom was second and the pace quickened up again. Still there was third. Caledonian Concord won off the fence. Orchestra Man got up on his inside. A length and a half away, Spend a Dollar, still trapped a little bit wide. Cartridge Case was third last. Our Orphan was second last, ridden quietly, and Tacloban last of all. Solo Bit jumps the next one well. Mighty Dom didn't. Still there, lost a bit of ground. Getting up on the fence was Orchestra Man, now goes to third inside, still there. Caledonian Concord was fifth. Then Spend a Dollar now gets up on the fence. Our Orphan about to improve. Cartridge Case was second last, and four lengths away, Tacloban. Solo Bit's measuring his fence as well. He's jumping about two and a half lengths clear at this stage of Spend a Dollar, which has made ground quickly on the inside of Mighty Dom, who keeps giving. Our Orphan made a good move up on the outside to go to fourth at the next one. Solo Bit jumps well. Spend a Dollar obviously didn't because it fell, and Tacloban and Orchestra Man got badly interfered with. So Spend a Dollar out of the race by the 1200, and Solo Bid leads a half length to Mighty Dom. A length away, Our Orphan and Cartridge Case has made ground. Two lengths away, fifth was still there. Two lengths to Caledonian Concord. About eight to Orchestra Man, Tacloban and Spend a Dollar fell. 1,000 metres to go. Mighty Dom went to a length lead over Solo Bid. On the outside was Our Orphan. Harnett hasn't gone for Solo Bid at the moment, although it's third now. Mighty Dom a half in front, second placing Our Orphan. A length away, third Solo Bid. The lead is gone. Mighty Dom's gone, and Our Orphan almost went over the top. He's lost all chance he had in the race, Our Orphan. The jockey come out of the irons and forget about him now, and Solo Bid's left in front. It's 10 lengths clear to Cartridge Case, and still there. Caledonian Concord was fourth as they run up towards the home turn. They got one to get over. Solo Bid's got a winning break. He's 10 or 12 lengths in front. Second placing Cartridge Case, then still there. Five to Caledonian Concord. It's a wonder Our Orphan is still on his feet. He's back in fifth place, and well back Orchestra Man, Tacloban, coming down to the last one. Will he get over it? Comes to it. He's over it. Solo Bit of Nuck. Nick Harnett about 15 lengths in front. They've got it well parcelled up from Cartridge Case, still there. Caledonian Concord, Our Orphan, Orchestra Man and Tacloban. And in a thrilling Pooley Bridge hurdle race, Solo Bit wins it easily. Helped along the way though. Three of them fell. Wins it about 15 lengths to Cartridge Case. Still there third. Then Our Orphan, lucky to stay on his feet. Caledonian Concord, Tacloban and Orchestra Man has run last.
Well, that was certainly an exciting hurdle race. I'm just...
joining in Caulfield, all clear, margins 15 lengths by two, Solo Bid 185 and 80. The time for the first was 324.6, and it suggests that the track is not all that bad. 324.6, 185 and 80, Cartridge Case 105, still there $1.50, Quinella 885 and the trifecta on 782, $142.90. Sydney Race 1, Starlight Angel won by a dozen lengths, 90 cents and 65, Bodonna 155, Peyton Black 55, Quinella $8.15 and the trifecta $21.05. Update for Sydney.
And almost sent the rider catapulting over the top. He stayed put there off and it jumped only fairly. One of the best away, Bold Walk with Sporting Fear and Zapari ridden up into the early part. Chateau be beaten for early speed as dropped back with Brazen Angel as they settle now. Zapari's going hard with Bold Walk and Sculptor's Daughter. Sporting Fear was there and so was My River Girl, who's joining in pretty quickly with those and getting up on the inside. Slander followed by Pack of Lies. They were followed by Folkestone Hero. A Filo was next, followed down on the inside by Some Kind, then Comedy Dancer, Cellar Melody, and right around the outside, Brazen Angel, four and five deep. Back on the inside, running next there was Super Ruler before the turn, followed well back by Shah Toby, and also Rock On, who's on the rail and out very deep on the track around those. Then came, making a bit of ground, Willow Gold. Into the straight they race now, and here the leader down on the inside running is Zapari. It shot away. Ran to the 200, three in front of Slander, Bold Walk battling on, and a filler coming late down the outside. Looks the only danger. A filler is gobbling up the turn. benefits after this leader, Zapari. Zapari is stopping. Afila is coming out at Afila races to Zapari. It's going to be a good go. Afila. Afila's got there. From Zapari, third placing, Rock On. A big effort. It might have got up for third. Close down the outside with a bold walk. Willow Gold drove home hard. They were followed out very wide by Tarawin. It got home from last near the turn. Further back in that group two came Some Kind and also Folkestone Hero. Bold walk pulling up quickly. Then Slander likewise, followed by Subaruna Sporting Fear, Cella Melody, Shah Toby. My River Girl capitulated. Well back too was Daring Comedy and walking past the post, Brazen Angel, and pulling up quickly with Sculptor's Daughter.
Over the line in Adelaide, Afila 650 and 175. These are interim dividends, Zapari 85. And if Rock On did get third, it'll be $7.70 for the second race in Adelaide today. Openers for... successful at 650 and 175. Zapari second at 85. Rock On 770. Good trifecta there, $3,660.55, and the Quinella was $10.20. Now the result in Melbourne race one, Solo bid 185 and 80. Cartridge Case $1.05. Still there 150. Quinella 885. Trifecta $142.90. Not only is it an exciting day in racing today with the big one in Brisbane and also in Adelaide, there's plenty of sport to think about. We've had some excellent results overseas this morning with golf and also tennis. And
Digo, 1200 the journey, starting on the course proper. Lion's Fire rocking around. Racing this time, All-Star Gazer was last out of the barrier stalls and still a conspicuous last, and Campania leads from Spinach. Chrome Blade a length away third, then Harvest Crop and Millennium Falcon, followed by Bull Decade, and then Lion's Fire, and pushing between horses after that slow start is Star Gazer from Chipolata Teen Dancer, and four lengths to Victory Note as they go towards the 850, and Spinach narrowly in front from Star Gazer three deep on the rails, Campania. Millennium Falcon caught four wide, then Lion's Fire with a nice run behind the pace, one Chrome Blade, Bold Decade going backwards, and then Harvest Crop and Chipolata Teen Dancer, and last is Victory Note. 600 metres to travel here. Moses riding the ears off Star Gazer, and the leader is Campania, about a neck or so on Spinach. Millennium Falcon third, fourth is Star Gazer, and Lion's Fire waiting for the run, and Chipolata is via the Cape. They're homeward bound. Campania the inside leading from Spinach on the outside. Star Gazer is third, and he flicks back and comes four and five wide on Lion's Fire. Approaching the 250, Campania is under the whip. Star Gazer still battling on. Spinach between them and down the outside, Lion's Fire. At the 150, Star Gazer goes out after Campania. Lion's Fire third. Star Gazer on the outside, put his head in front. By golly, this is a run. Star Gazer comes away now from Campania and Lion's Fire. And Star Gazer missed the kick, but too good at the judge. Star Gazer beats Campania third, Lion's Fire, followed by Spinach. Then came Chipolata, Teen Dancer, Chrome Blade, a Long Gap, Millennium Falcon, Bold Decade, Harvest Crop, and last all the way, Victory Note.
Over the line in Sydney, 8-Star Gazer, another one for the Sire Star Way. This one trained by Tommy Smith, Kevin Moses, a jockey. $1.10 and 65, the interims. Campania, number 6, $1.10. Lion's Fire at 70 cents for Sydney. Race number 2, 8, 6 and 1. Openers race 3, $1.10. Lion's Fire, number 170. Quinella was 6.60. Trifecta, $27.85. And the running double on a pair of favourites in Sydney, the first two races, $2 even. Update for Melbourne, race number 2. And as Terry Clifton said, not much between Friar's Delight and our Palliser in the ring.
View of Italian barrier number 3 in their racing. Designation one of three grades was the best to begin from the inside of View. Lord Figura next, Pacific Mirage allowed to drop back and Obstinate going up towards the lead. Friar's Delight getting across to be about fifth. Look at Sir Ramazan from the outside stall, zips across in front of the field and leads by the winning post the first time. Now designation is second, Cliffman went up on the outside third, View fourth the fence. Then Obstinate followed by Sir Agrafo, won the Grand National Hurdle 2 years ago. It moves up on the outside of Friar's Delight. right. Two lengths to Lord Figura inside our Palliser. A length and a half back on the inside, Pagliacci, followed by Arapaho Indian. Impertinent Charge was second last, and Pacific Mirage, the former Kiwi, last of all. About 1,700 metres left to travel, and Sir Ramazan in front. At least by three or four lengths to Designation second, and the pace is okay for a mile and a half race. Cliffman was third, Sir Agrafo fourth, the outside. A length and a half to Obstinate Outside View. About three lengths away, Friars Delight travelling comfortably. Two and a half to Lord Figura. Then our Palliser, two lengths to Arapaho Indian, followed by Pagliacci on the inside of Impertinent Charge. And about two and a half lengths away, Pacific Mirage. About 15 lengths between first from last as they run up the hill towards the 1200. And Sir Amazon in front by the halfway point, about two lengths clear. Now going up on the outside to second was Sir Agrafo on the outside of Designation, who's had good cover throughout. Cliffman was fourth, two lengths to View, two and a half to Friars Delight. Then Lord Figura inside our Palliser, Impertinent Charge, Obstinate going backwards. Arapaho Indian got up on its inside, Pacific Mirage taken wide, and Pagliacci at the rear, in fact, has gone past Obstinate now as they run down the railway side, about 900 to go. And Sir Amazon unchallenged in front, little length and a half to Sir Agrafo. Designation pushed along on the inside, Friars Delight starting to move forward very quickly. Then Cliffman followed by View, our Palliser made up ground from Arapaho Indian. Pacific Mirage going around them wide, followed by Lord Figura, break Pagliacci. Inside the 600, Sir Amazon, the one they've got to catch, a little length and a half. Friars Delight travelling well, went to second, our Palliser goes to third. Pacific Mirage went to fourth, then Sir Agrafo under pressure, running to the home turn, 300 metres to go. Friars Delight got to Sir Amazon, the two dangers, our Palliser and Pacific Mirage run on. Friars Delight kicked the length in front, our Palliser comes at it. Hall goods the lip in the right hand, it's coming out after Friars Delight, then Sir Amazon, Pacific Mirage. It's Friars Delight still a length in front. Our Palliser can't pick it back. Friars Delight's a length and a half clear. It's got a winning break and she's too good for them. The Watermore Cup winner's going to win and by two and a half lengths. Friars Delight first, our Palliser second. View got going again for third in front of Sir Amazon, Pacific Mirage and Cliffman. Then Designation, Sir Agrafo, Lord Figura, Impertinent Charge, Pagliacci and Arapaho Indian was last of all.
Well,
no, it wasn't.
Ready now. Ansett Golden Wing and they're winging their way now with I'm a Gambler, one of the best away near the inside, and another hurdler, Regal Dan, going with it. Then came the big fellow, Towering Trojan, working up towards them. Geely easing back as Perfect Message went up on its inside from Strictly Irish. Caught Deep Southern Quest, Ventuno and Ella Rama. Getting through along the inside is Tax Revenue and Speedy Chevelle's one of the last. As they settle fully by the 2,000 metre mark, and here it's Towering Trojan, the outside, and down on the inside, Regal Dan pulling. A length away behind them, Perfect Message, sitting on the outside of I'm a Gambler, two and a half away to Strictly Irish, which looks to have settled down fairly well. Geely on its inside over the 1800 crossing from Heavenly Bray, Tax Revenue, Southern Quest. Ella Rama next and the last pair together, Speedy Chevelle on the inner and covering it on the outside there, Ventuno. Shaping up to the far side of the course by the 1650, and here it's Regal Dan, a narrow leader, drawing now as I speak about a half in front of Towering Trojan. They're under restraint. So too in third, Posse is I'm a Gambler, who's pulling. He's got his head on his chest. Over on the outside, Perfect Message, two to Strictly Irish, and then Geely. Heavenly Bray next, they're only going leisurely. Further back in the field, Ella Rama, three deep around Southern Quest, Tax Revenue, the rail. Two lengths away to Ventuno on the outside of Speedy Chevelle. A little bit more pace coming into the race as they go towards the 1200 now. And here the leader still is Regal down the inside by a half length, Towering Trojan, the outer. A length and a half away, Perfect Message, sitting on the outside of I'm a Gambler. Two lengths to Strictly Irish with Geely, it's inside. A length then to Heavenly Bray, Tax Revenue and Ella Rama going around them. Then Southern Quest, followed by Ventuno, popped a question, and last Speedy Chevelle on the inside. Going to the 900 metre mark, and Regal Dan still about a half, three quarters in front of Towering Trojan, and the pace quickens now. A length away behind those, going to the 800 metre point, then came Perfect Message, and Strictly Irish and Southern Quest are off quickly. Down on the inside, I'm a Gambler, then Geely getting away from the rail and pumped up. Tax Revenue went with it, and further back Southern Quest, and around the outside of those came Ventuno, and forget Speedy Chevelle. Homeward bound now as they swing past the 600 metre point, and here the southeasterner Southern Quest has dropped right out, and Heavenly Bray sped to the lead with Strictly Irish, followed then by Geely getting into the clear. Out wide a Perfect Message, then Regal Dan, Towering Trojan's gone. Homeward bound, Heavenly Bray went to a narrow lead. In second placing, Perfect Message is trying to peg it back. Geely there, then Strictly Irish running out of steam. They were followed further back in the fiddle. Geely and Perfect Message are having a bumping duel behind Heavenly Bray. Heavenly Bray in front of Perfect Message. Geely lost the duel. Then came Tax Revenue late down the outside.
inside. Perfect Message went to Heavenly Bray, and Perfect Message is going to be Too Solid. Won by about a length to second on the inside, Heavenly Bray. Now third's tight. Gilly, Tax Revenue in the centre, and right down the outside, Southern Quest from Ellorama. Well back in the field behind those, then came Ventuno, I'm a Gambler, Strictly Irish, a shocker. Regal Dan, Towering Trojan, and tailed off Speedy Chevelle.
Over the line in Adelaide, six Perfect Message successful from two Heavenly Bray. And it is pretty tight there for third. Now, I'm not sure if Heavenly Bray, in fact, has hung on for second either. So if you've taken a Quinella, don't give up if you're in that photo. But Perfect Message. Regal Prize 220, Corkage 190, Anybody Home 175, Minuscule at 180, and Miss Remus at $3.80. In Adelaide, race number three, Perfect Message successful at 1085, 265, and Southern Quest did get second at 270, number nine. Heavenly Bray relegated to third, number two, at 115. Quinella, 156.15, and the trifecta was $2,989.75. Totes for Melbourne race number three, Vibrant Night is 120, London Road 355.
They've jumped away as one, and Regal Prize is the early leader. Second placing is Monusco. Third on the inside, Corkage, and then Miss Remus and Anybody Home. So it's Moses in front aboard Regal Prize. Down to the 100 metres, they canter, and Regal Prize about a length on Monusco. Corkage on the inside, the centre is Anybody Home, and three deep is Miss Remus. Miss Remus, the only female in the race, and the other four are all geldings. Now, as they turn out of the straight, and Regal Prize from Tuttock Lodge leads the way a bit more than a length on Monusco. Miss Remus racing on the outside of Corkage and a length Anybody Home. No change in the order as they go over the crossing at the 1800 metres, and Regal Prize leads the way. Miss Remus starting to go up on the outside of Monusco. She's three away from the inside rail as Monusco holds his position a horse away from the fence. Corkage on the inside of Anybody Home. So the five horses racing within about four lengths of one another as they swing the second corner here and race to the back of the course near the 1500 metres, and Regal Prize a length and a half. Second is Miss Remus, a length Monusco. One and a half then to Anybody Home and a half to Corkage on the inner. Down the back of the course they run. And who's going to be the first jockey to make a move from behind the rider on Regal Prize, Kevin Moses? As they run down the back of the track now on Regal Prize, the speed is reasonable here. It's about three quarters of a length on Miss Remus. On the inside is Monusco, and then Anybody Home niggled out a shade by Gwilliam, and Corkage is last. Racing onto the next bend at the 1,000 metres, and Regal Prize by a length. Second placing is Miss Remus and Monusco on the inside of Anybody Home. William riding the ears off Anybody Home, and Corkage last about five lengths from the leader, Regal Prize. Heading to the side at 800 metres, and Regal Prize only about a neck on Miss Remus, a length and a half to Monusco, and one to Anybody Home, and a half to Corkage, pocketed on the inside as they come down to the 650. And a Regal Prize almost joined in front now by on the outside as they move up to approach the home corner here. And I refer to Miss Remus. Now, what's Monusco's rider going to do here? He's about to pull around the two leaders. And as they turn the corner, Regal Prize, Miss Remus, and now Monusco goes after them. A long margin to Corkage, and Anybody Home is last. 250 left to travel. Regal Prize on the inside, headed by Miss Remus. Monusco trying hard to reach them on the outside. Now Regal Prize is gone. Miss Remus grabbed by Monusco. Monusco and Miss Remus, the mare and the gelding, on the outside. Monusco, will his condition last? Third up from a spill, Miss Remus fighting back. Monusco doing better as they hit the line. Monusco! Monusco and nose Miss Remus. Regal Prize third. Fourth Anybody Home. Fifth and last Corkage, who didn't handle the heavy conditions.
Small field, but a very good finish. Monusco getting there to win from Miss Remus over the line in Sydney. And Regal Prize in third placing. So it looks to be 4, 5 and 1 over the line in Sydney after race number three. Now the totes for race four in Sydney, where the scratching is number 9, Y King, Cold Hearted 670, General Reserve, Third Dividend, Quinella 570, Running Double 880, Trifecta 2370, Adelaide race number 3, the winner there was Perfect Message at 1085 and 270, Southern Quest 270, Heavenly Bray 110, Trifecta 2989.75, Quinella 156.15, Des Spain, what did you think of?
So I'd say that dog has been caught Now, Mushroom Lad veered down the track a little bit. It's about to return to the starting stalls. Once it does go in, they'll just about be set to go.
Right, get off the track, boys. Move back.
There you go. It wasn't me, it wasn't you, Des. But a stern warning there. Now, Mushroom Lad again got away from the stalls. A couple of horses back in the race. Vibrant Knight's been well supported. Good money for Ollie's Gold, a first starter by God's Walk out of Miss Ollie. And there's been strong money for the Centane colt, Rising Wind. His only appearance, he ran third to Capello and Impressionism on the 10th of January at Flemington. Now, Mushroom Lad, which will start from the outside stall, is coming up to the gates. It moves up with a baldy face. Hang on, sounds like Greg Hall. Lights on, and they're racing. London Road beat them out over on the inside, and look at Marshall begin very quickly.